I believe. I believe that you have something in your hand. I believe that you have a God-given talent. You have gifts. You have abilities. And you have skills. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. This is Rick Young, another segment of What's in Your Hand at WHCR 90.3 FM. You want to hear something funny? I actually was listening to some of my earlier shows, and man, I've really grown. You could hear the growth in my voice and the way I'm speaking. I'm like, wow, it was really... There were times I asked some good questions, but I was like, wow, I have grown. I'm happy about that. I'm very happy about that. So this is What's in Your Hand at WHCR 90.3 FM, the voice of Harlem. And I am honored to be here. And before we get started, I want to just give a tribute to a gentleman. His name is John Powers. And I interviewed him, I think it was around 2008. And he had a program called Five Disciplines of Powerful People, and he was a great guest, and one in the five disciplines, and he sent me an audio program of the five disciplines. And so the five disciplines, what are the five disciplines of powerful people? This is what John Powers said that they were. He said that first, it was the promise. And it was about keeping the promises to yourself. Sometimes people say things, I want to do this, I want to do that, and they don't keep those promises. It's very important to keep a promise. The second principle was passion. And I believe that it's very important that you find that passion. Like, for me, getting up 4 o'clock in the morning to come to a studio is truly passion. Truly passion. To be able to share, give, and be a platform for success. This is strictly about a success show. Strictly. And then the third principle is planning. And I believe that that's important. You want to do something, right? You should have a plan, right? Planning, blueprint. You want to put up a building, you got to have that blueprint. You're not going to put up a building without a blueprint. So planning is very important. And the fourth principle is persistence. And it took me a persistent effort to get here this morning because I thought that someone was going to pick me up. But, you know, that happens. They didn't pick me up this morning. You know, one of those things. So, but I had persistence to get here because I went down, I saw the subway, it said, it's coming in 2 minutes. So I said, okay, I'll give it a shot. 2 minutes, it's coming. Then it said 1 minute, right? And 5 minutes later, it was still saying 1 minute. I'm like, wait a minute, what's going on here? I'm looking, I don't see anything coming. I'm like, whoa. I'm like, wow, this is a trip. You know what? I'm going to take a quick break for a second, and I will be right back.
He said, well, David. Huh?
just know enough. Life out here is mighty rough. All these things I can't control.
Wow, that sounds real good. That is Sounds of Blackness. They're sounding real good. So the last, so we said persistence was the fourth principle. And the last one is progress. I guess you have to make your progress. Because when you do all the other P's, you will make progress. With that said, we're having a party this morning. This is like a party. Because usually it's not like this. I've had multiple guests before. But this is a party. This is truly a party. So I want to say hi to my guest, my in-studio guest, Felicity. How are you doing this morning?
Very well, thank you.
Very well.
A bit cranky.
I hear an accent.
Yes, I'm from London in the UK.
Now, I want you to know I've been to London.
Mm-hmm. Did you like it?
Yeah, it was very interesting. And I also went to Hull.
To Hull.
Everybody laughs when I say I went to Hull. We went to Hull. We went there for boxing.
Okay, yeah.
I was, at that time, I was an amateur boxer. I was with the USA boxing team. Mm-hmm. And we did, there was another guy in my weight class. So he boxed in Hull and I boxed in Ireland.
Okay.
I think maybe it should have been the other way around because in my match in Ireland, I suffered a hairline fracture and I lost that bout. But, that's just one of those things. But I came back and became professional, so I guess I did have the persistence that John Powers talked about. Yeah. Oh, one other thing I want to mention before I get started. So yesterday, I emailed this other guy about being on my show because he has a program called Willpower. And I sent him an email. I said, man, I'd like for him to be a guest on my show. He sent me an email back. He says, I'm not doing any work right now. My daughter just passed away. I said, wow. So John Powers passed away last year, I found out. I just thought that was interesting that all this stuff is happening like right now. And so that brings us to today with you. And Felicity, let me just say really quickly, you're having a seminar, workshops, open castings. This is called Actors Pro Expo 2014. Tell me quickly about this.
Yeah, Actors Pro Expo is an actors trade show. We're running at Radisson Martinique on Broadway on April 26th, and it's basically an event for actors to network with other like-minded people, grow within their own abilities, learn from seminars, attend an open casting, and also meet companies that they might need within their careers face-to-face. So that's what the event is all about.
Now, that lady sitting next to you, to your right, she's my boxing student. Where I teach boxing at. But let me tell you, Hollywood is, they ain't ready until they see this young lady here. and so we're having a party this morning.
Yes, we are.
And so with that said, I'm going to bring in my other, we're going to do this, like we're going to work it together. We're going to celebrate together. So I want to welcome on the line, I have on the line, D's. Good morning, D. How are you doing? D, are you there?
I am.
Okay.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you now. Can you hear me now? Are you working with Verizon? Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now?
I can hear
you. So, now, D, where are you located?
I'm in Arizona, right outside of Phoenix.
Arizona, outside of Phoenix. Have you ever been to the UK?
Yes, I have, actually. It's been quite some time.
Okay.
In the 1970s, I believe, I was in London.
Okay. I've been to London before. We're going to do some networking this morning.
Great.
I want you to say hi to Felicity. She's doing an actors workshop. It's called Actors Pro Expo, where they're going to have seminars, workshop, and open casting. Excuse me. Say hi to Felicity.
Okay. Hi, Felicity. Good to meet you.
Hi, lovely to meet you. By the radio.
you hear that accent? D, you hear that accent?
Yes, I do. I hear it.
And we also have another lady in the studio, too. Her name is Cassinia, and she's making faces now. She takes boxing classes with me, and she wants to go professional boxing, so we'll see. So say hi to Cassinia.
Hi, Cassinia.
Hi.
Wait, I didn't cut her mic on. Say hi.
Hello.
Now, Dee, really quickly, tell us a little bit about what you do.
Well, I help people get their stories written, the stories of their lives, so that they'll have something to hand on to future generations other than just material things. And I do this through teaching workshops. I have a book out, and I actually help people do the writing as well, you know, by interviewing them and then getting the writing done for them, or sometimes they'll write it and I'll edit it. And I've done about a dozen books this way, and I just think it's so important for people to write about their life, you know, the challenges and the successes and all of that, so that their children and grandchildren can learn in that way. Right now we think we, you know, nobody's going to care about our life, but I guarantee you that in 50, 70, 100 years, people will look back and wonder what our lives were like, the people who don't know us.
Right, that's very interesting. Now, your name is Dee Dees?
That's it. I married that. So my first name's actually Dolores, but I've always been called Dee, and then I married a man whose last name was Dees.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so we're going to be going. So for anyone that's listening, I think it's very important that you have a pen and paper, because there's going to be a lot of information going on. We're having I'm calling this a What's in Your Hand party this morning. We're going to have just multiple guests. In order to keep up, you probably should take a pen and write down the information. You never know how this might help you. So, Dee Dees, you are in Arizona, right?
Mm-hmm. That's right.
And what's the name of your program? You're called the Story Lady, right?
The Life Story Lady.
The Life
Story Lady.
Okay, I'm taking notes here.
Uh-huh.
And Felicity. Now, let me ask you really, we're going to be going back and forth, guys, so just work with me, okay? Is that okay, Dee?
That works for me.
Because it's like, I see you guys as being sort of connected in a way. Because when you're acting, you're telling a story. Would you agree with that, Felicity?
Yeah, absolutely.
Sorry, go ahead, say it again.
Yes, absolutely.
Now, Felicity, how did you get into acting?
I studied acting at drama school, and then when I graduated, I basically came up with the idea of this actors event, which I started running in London, and then I pushed it out to Manchester and Edinburgh, and then it's kind of taken over, and now I brought it to New York.
Wow, that's pretty impressive. Dee, do you know the name of this radio program?
Yes, it's What's in Your Hand.
What's in Your Hand, right.
Yeah, I didn't know there was going to be a test.
The test is just getting started. The test is just getting started. So basically this show is about, in my opinion, it's about success and achievement and using your, what I call your tags, your talents, your abilities, your gifts, and your skills. So, Dee, can you give me your definition of success?
I think it's doing what you love and just being happy in your life. I believe that it doesn't really matter how much money you have, because I know a lot of people with a lot of money who are not happy, and people with no money that are very happy. So for me, that's it. If you're happy and you're doing what you love in your work, then that's success in my book.
Mm-hmm. And Felicity, what is your definition of success?
I would definitely agree with what Dee said. I think, you know, doing what you love is a huge amount of happiness. And my other thing is just being free as well. You know, having the freedom to you know, do whatever you particularly want to do that day. And freedom comes from, you know, having a job with flexibility, having a partner who supports you, all of those kind of things. So I think doing what you love and having freedom is what I believe is success.
Mm-hmm. Now, Ksenia was supposed to just be coming to hang out with me, but I just need to know, what is her definition of success? Bring the mic down a little bit.
Oh. Yeah, I agree with both ladies. It's definitely being happy with what you do. Like, in your everyday life and with whatever is going on around you. As long as you're happy, as long as you're satisfied, that's good. That's the success, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
That's where we all should be going.
Okay. Okay. Now, D, how did you become the story lady? I'm going to have to emphasize that, D, you're in Arizona, so anybody that comes on later can kind of catch up to us and where we are. So, D, you're in Arizona, near Phoenix, right?
Yes.
So, how did you become the story lady?
Well, I got interested in this because I started writing my grandmother's life story when she was in her 90s. And after doing that, going through that process, because I had tried to get her to write her own life story, and she just said, she came up with a lot of reasons why she couldn't. You know, she couldn't remember all of that. She didn't know where to start. Nobody cared. Those were all her excuses. So I started interviewing her and getting her to write them down. And then it just hit me one night that if I could break this down into small chunks, small steps, then it's something anybody could do, because what I had her doing was just answer one question at a time. So I ended up writing a workbook, and from the workbook I started teaching classes and workshops, and then from that I started actually helping other people write their stories and interviewing them. Because some people just don't have the discipline to sit down and write it themselves, even though to me it seems like the easiest thing in the world, it is difficult for some people. So then I would go interview those people and write for them. So it just developed over a period of about 15 minutes into a business where now I mostly help other people write their stories.
Well, Dee, I'm going to ask you one of the most difficult questions that you've ever been asked before. Are you ready?
Okay.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
So being that we have Felicity here in the studio, who you know she's has an acting program that she's doing here in New York, and she's into the acting world. And so if someone had to play your story to be you in the movie, the D.D. story, who would you pick to be that, to play you?
You know, it's going to be somebody that the younger people probably won't even remember, and that's Doris Day. She just turned 90, but I've always been a big fan of hers, and sometimes people tell me I look a little bit like her. So certainly a similar hairstyle, but I would absolutely choose Doris Day.
Wow.
Maybe Mary Tyler Moore would be a second choice.
Okay. Felicity, do you remember Doris Day?
No.
Do you remember Mary Tyler Moore?
No.
Ooh. They were good actresses. So you got to do your research.
I am the worst person with famous actors. I honestly, considering the world that I work in, I never, ever know who people are.
Yeah. Well, who's one of your, other than yourself, who's one of the famous actresses that you admire their work right now?
I think right now I really admire people that are more than just actors. So they're writing and they're also producing. So people like from the States, someone like Lena Dunham, I really respect.
Who's that?
Lena Dunham.
I'm not familiar.
She's at that famous show Girls.
Girls.
You know,
yeah.
Girls, yeah.
I'm not watching too much TV these days.
Yeah, it's on HBO. And and then in the UK, there's someone similar called Noel Clarke. And he is, he's a writer. Do you know Noel Clarke? Oh, I don't know if he's famous here. He's a writer, producer, and directs as well. And so I really respect actors who are basically similar to actually what Dee's saying, who basically have a story and make it be told by writing it and producing it and acting in the films.
Mm-hmm. So I'm going back and forth between Dee and Felicity, and Dee is in Phoenix, Arizona, and Felicity's here in the studio, and Felicity's doing this actors seminar workshop, which I think is going to be great, and it's going to be, when is it, next week, right? What's the date on?
Saturday, 26th.
April 26th, a Saturday from 10 to 5. It's going to be at the Radisson Martinique on Broadway, 49th West 32nd Street. And now, what if you don't have a side card or an after card? Can you still attend?
Yes, you can still attend. It's open to all.
Okay. All right. This is a very interesting show. I need to take a quick D, hold on for a second. We're going to take a quick break, right?
Okay.
1 second. Everything's gonna be all right. All right.
But you don't notice me. Everything's gonna be all right.
Oh, I hear an echo.
All right.
Why am I hearing an echo? D, are you there?
I'm here.
Okay. I don't know why I'm hearing an echo. So D, tell me, what does your ideal client customer look like?
Actually, it's somebody that I just finished a book for, and it was somebody who had been well known here in Phoenix, not nationally certainly, but he was able to do a lot of the writing himself, and I did editing, and I did help him, you know, pull stories out. There were some things he just really had a hard time writing about. And so, you know, I would talk to him and just kind of pull the stories out from him, and I wrote some. But for the most part, he did a lot of the writing, and then I would just edit it and put it all in order, you know, get it organized and turn it into a book. But that was fun because we were able to really keep his voice, and everybody who has read the book has said, you know, they can really hear him talking and telling the stories. So that's the best kind, is when the people reading can actually hear their loved one telling the story.
Wow. Well, you know what? You're gonna meet some. You're gonna meet some very interesting people today. You met Felicity, and
yes.
You met Cassinia. Felicity is from the UK.
Mm-hmm.
You met Cassinia, who's from. I think did she say KGB? No, I'm just kidding. But she's from Russia. I think that's how you say it. Russia. Oh, that's how I say it. Okay. And then we have another guest that just stepped into the studio, D. And her name is Lori Cheeks, and she's going to tell you a little bit about what she does. Tell us a little bit about what you do, Lori.
So I'm the founder.
Go ahead.
I'm the founder and CEO of a fun new way to meet someone in the real world. It's a dating site called Cheeked.com. So let's say you spot an intriguing stranger in your morning commute. At your locker or at the gym, you can pull out your deck of cheeked cards, and they're shaped like a business card. And on one side, the card says you've been cheeked, and on the other side, there's an ice-breaking pickup line that you can hand to an attractive stranger, such as act natural, we can get awkward later, or there's one that says I saw you checking me out, or maybe you're at the bar, you could slip them the card that says I just put all my drinks on your tab. Anyway, there's a code on that card that the recipient would type in at cheeked.com or on the app, and they would find your online dating profile. So it's a little bit like a business card, but for dating, and there's no personal information on it.
Can I see your card? Did you bring some cards?
Of course.
Did you bring some for me and for Cassina?
Well, these all lead to me, so you'll find a very beautiful blonde woman when you type in this code.
And so we have Cassinia here.
Hi.
She's so here, from...
This says I'm hitting on you.
Wow.
She's from... Cassinia's from... Lori?
Yes.
Cassinia's from Russia. Russia.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Russia.
That's awesome.
And Felicity's from the UK.
Okay.
And let me just tell you, Felicity has a program coming up. It's called Actors Pro Expo, New York 2014. And basically, it's an actors convention by actors for actors. It's going to be at the Radisson Monteek on Broadway, 49 West 32nd Street. Next Saturday, April 26th, from 10 to 5. Right? So that's who Felicity is.
Let's go.
Right? And Cassina is, she's supposed to just be hanging out with me.
Yeah.
But she's my boxing student at the club that I teach.
Oh.
Yeah. I teach boxing.
She looks a little dangerous.
Yeah. She's been training a little bit, so.
A little bit?
And then, now wait a minute, Laurie. On the line, I have D, her name is D D's, and she's called the Life Story Lady. Isn't that cool?
Hi, Laurie.
Hi, D D's.
That's it.
So
name and last name.
So I'm gonna pick on you for a minute. Oh no, wait this. We're gonna get back to you 1 second, D.
Okay.
So the first question that I asked everybody is, what was their definition of success? So Laurie, what is your definition of success?
I mean, I was an architect before, and 6 years ago I came up with this idea, and
you were an architect.
Yeah.
So you were building relationships.
Before, I was building structures and designing spaces.
Now you're structuring relationships.
Yes, I'm building bridges for relationships.
Ooh, all right.
And, you know, I think a lot of people come up with ideas in life, but actually bringing the idea to fruition is my idea of success. And I've been able to keep this business alive for 4 years on a bootstrap budget. So it's all over the world. We've got customers in Russia. We've got customers in the UK. And we've got customers all over, so I feel like that's a level of success that I would have looked forward to starting this business.
Okay, this is a question for everybody here. Who here in this room is an expert in marketing? Also, that goes for you too, Adi. Who's the expert in marketing? Who would be the most proficient at that?
I mean, I think that's the one thing I've done flawlessly starting my business is marketing and PR.
Okay, all right. So let me go back to D. So D.
Yes.
Do you mind if I pick on you for a minute?
Not at all. Go ahead.
And time is just flying by. So you just heard Laurie Cheek's story. What if you had to do a story about Laurie? Give me an example of how that would look, because you are the story lady.
Well, okay, yeah.
Can you do that? Is that okay?
About her background, I'm intrigued with the idea that she was an architect, because that's something I always thought I would like to do.
Wow.
If I had thought about that in my younger days, I would have loved doing that. I would just, if I were writing her story, I would just sit down with her for a couple of hours and talk to her and ask her about her background and what made her become interested in architecture, first of all, and then that's kind of a big leap from architecture to the, you know, the dating cards, and that intrigues me too. So I would just ask those questions and try to write it up as much in her words as I could, or have her write it, and then I could, you know, polish it and turn it into a book.
All right. I like that. I think Laurie, like, she's smiling. I don't think she likes that. I think y'all might be doing some business together.
Well, you never know.
Okay. So now we got Felicity here, the actress, the performer from the UK. So how would her story look from your perspective of short time knowing her?
Yeah, well, I would probably couch hers more in theatrical terms, I'm sure. You know, and again, I don't know that much about the the acting industry, but I would certainly do some research and find out what I could, and then again, you know, find out what makes her tick, what got her interested in that in the first place. You know, find out things like was she in school plays as a child? Where does she want to be 10 or 15 years from now in that profession? Those are the kinds of questions I like to ask. And also, the two questions that I ask everybody that I think are the most important are, what are the greatest challenges you've had in your life, and what are the greatest successes in your life? Because we learn from both of those.
Hey, Dee, I just got some news for you, some breaking news. Breaking news, Dee, you and I are going to be good friends.
Okay.
I just got that feeling. I got that feeling. I love how you're talking. I love how you talked about Felicity Now, there's a young lady called Cassinia in here. Her head is going from side to side, and she's smiling. And she's from the UK, and she's, I think she's the, no, not from the UK, from Russia. She gave me a crazy look when I said UK. She loves her Russia, boy. She loves it. Okay. I think she's the only child. Spoiled. Woo. I think her mom is like a, your mom is like a world traveler, right?
Yeah. She,
yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
So, just a quick assessment. What would you do with Cassinia? I know you don't know a lot about her,
and
but
I'm a boxer.
I know. And that's, I mean, that just boggles my mind right there. You know, why a you know, young woman would want to get into boxing. Yeah. I don't know. I don't
She hasn't got hit yet.
More than slapping a guy maybe is the most fighting I've ever done. But
yeah.
So see, but that's what I love about what I do is everybody is so different, and I just, you know, I always want to know what makes people tick and why they are who they are.
Okay. Wow. All right. Well, guess what? We need to take a quick break, and we're going to take a quick break, D. Would you hold on and hang out with us?
I'll hold on for a while.
And we'll take a quick break, and we're going to come back, and then you got to talk about guess who? Guess who you got to do an assessment on?
Uh-oh.
Take a guess. Some guy. Some guy. Can you...
I'm thinking it's you.
So we're going to take a short break.
Okay.
And come back and do the, hold on a second. I'm just setting this up. So, D, hold on a second, all right? We'll be right back, okay?
Okay.
All right. See you in a minute.
Yeah. WCR 90.3 FM, New York.
The Educational Theater Program at the City College of New York proudly presents the 2014 Family Arts Day, Saturday, May 10th from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. Family Arts Day offers free fun for everyone. There will be theater games, face painting, puppets, sing-alongs, clowns and mask making, live performances, and much more. That's Family Arts Day, Saturday, May 10th from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m., held at Aaron Davis Hall on the campus of the City College of New York at 135th Street and Convent Avenue. For a full schedule of events and directions, visit www.ccny.cuny.edu/edtheater.
The first Islamic Film Festival occurs May 3rd through May 4th at the Malcolm X Betty Shabazz Center, 3940 Broadway near 165th Street in Manhattan. For information, 917-946-8903, 917-946-8903. The film festival features Al Ghazali, The Trials of Muhammad Ali, Return to Goree, and 8 Centuries of Islam in America. May 3rd through May 4th. Information 917-946-8903, presented by the Mosque of Islamic Brotherhood Communications Department.
WHCR, the Greater Harlem Chamber of Commerce, the New York Academy of Medicine, Emblem Health, Metro Plus, Health First, and City Care invite you and your family to the National Urban Health Conference held April 25th through April 27th. The National Urban Health Conference will feature major presentations on building healthy communities, spiritual health, and an all-day conference on youth health issues. All events of the National Urban Health Conference are free and open to the public, but space is limited. For a full schedule and to register, please call 212-862-7200 or visit www.greaterharlemchamber.com.
WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
This is Reverend Calvin Butts. I'm a supporter of WHCR and their efforts to inform and entertain our community. Beloved, listen carefully to WHCR. You will be inspired, you will be informed, and you will be a better citizen and, of course, a better family member here in Harlem. Thank you.
You're listening to WHCR 90.3 FM, the voice of Harlem.
Take your time, baby, don't you rush a thing. Don't you know I know we all are struggling. I know it is hard, but we will get by. And if you don't believe in me, just believe in him. Yes. 'Cause he'll give you peace of mind.
Yes, and we definitely have a peace of mind. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Rick Young, another segment of What's in Your Hand at WHCR 90.3 FM, the voice of Harlem. What's in Your Hand is a show about success, achievement, and reaching your dreams. And let me reintroduce my guest. Let me start in Arizona. We have DD's. And she's known as the Life Story Lady. How to help you put your life into a story form, and she'll get more into that as we continue on. And I have Felicity Jackson. She has a program called Actors Pro Expo New York 2014. An actors convention by actors and for actors. Wow. This is going to take place on April 26, 2014 from 10 to 5 p.m. I think that even if you're not an actor, I think you should kind of show up and just kind of be in a different environment and network and meet people. Just never know what might happen. And then I have Miss Lori Cheeks, who's in the studio. And she has a program called You've Been Cheeked. It's called, what is the business called, Lori?
Cheeked. You've Been Cheeked.
Cheeked. It's called Cheeked or You've Been Cheeked.
Well, it's Cheeked, but when you get cheeked, you've been cheeked.
Okay, now how does this code work?
So you could either download the app on iOS or Android. Mm-hmm. And you can easily type in that code and you find the profile of the person that hands you the card. Then you can chat with them on the app, or you can even find them on cheek.com, but then you'll have to download our app.
Right. Now, how do you find out if this person is a stalker or not?
Well, you know, anyone could be a stalker. Like, the idea of this is you're not looking for people on the internet. I think this is even a safer way of finding someone because you see them in person and you can get a lot. You can get a lot more about that person by actually seeing them in the real world than finding someone on the internet. So I think you just have to trust your gut when you slip someone one of these cards and hope that they might be the love of your life and not scary after all.
Well, you met the love of your life. Did you cheat the love of your life? Because I know you're married now.
I'm not married.
But you met your...
I met a guy I was with for a couple of years.
Mm-hmm. And you met him, did you cheek him?
I did cheek him.
Wow. And when you cheeked him, what was his response?
He said, well, your phone number's not on here. And I said, if you want to know me, you're going to have to type in this code from the card. And he did.
Okay. He didn't say that. That's too much work. He didn't say that?
No.
Okay. Wow. And then when he typed in the code, then what happened?
Well, he found me and he had to write me a little intro. So he wrote something nice and then we met up and we never really left each other's side. But
wow,
it didn't work out because I worked too much.
You said it didn't work out?
Yeah, in the end. We were together for a couple of years. So now I'm single again and I get to use my cheat cards all over again.
Okay. Okay. So, Felicity, how did you come up with this idea to start this actors? How and why did you come up with this Actors Pro Expo? Felicity Jackson.
I basically came up with the idea because I had a lot of, you know, friends that were actors that were struggling to find work. And I basically wanted to put together an event which gives people a place to go where they can meet other actors that are finding it difficult, and they can go to seminars and workshops and meet companies face to face. It was a difficult time when I set it up. It was 4.5 years ago, so it was kind of right in the beginning of the recession. But you know, and what we really, you know, how we make money is from vendors and sponsors. So obviously that's people's marketing budgets, and any kind of recession, the first thing that goes is marketing.
So which that should be the last thing to go.
Yeah, exactly. So it was 4.5 years ago, and yeah, we're now, this is the fourth city that we're now in. So it, it obviously works, and it's actually similar to Cheeked in some ways, because it's kind of mixing the real world with the online world, because a lot of the companies that come are online, and so they get the opportunity at the event to actually meet their customers face to face, and that means so much more than you know, always being just on the internet. And actually similar to what you were saying, you know, about that it's great when your guests actually, you know, come into the space and you can speak to people face to face. So I think that Actors Pro Expo is an opportunity to get face to face networking with people that can help your career.
Okay. And DD's in Arizona. What part of Arizona? You said you're outside of Phoenix, but what city are you in exactly?
I'm in Gilbert.
Oh, Gilbert, Arizona.
Yes, which is southeast of Phoenix, about 25 miles.
Have you ever been to New York?
Oh, absolutely.
How do you like New York?
I love it. Yeah, I was only there once for 4 days, but I saw every bit I could see.
Mm. So here's the deal, D. Listen to me very carefully. I think that you and I need to work together because I got at least about 100 people that need to write their story.
Okay, that sounds great.
And I think, hold on a second, D.
WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Rick Young, another segment of What's in Your Hand at WHCR 90.3 FM, The Voice of Harlem. And we are emanating from the campus of City College in New York. This is an institution of higher learning. And we're definitely doing some higher learning today, this morning. We're learning about getting cheeked. We're learning about acting. And we're learning about telling your story. I think that's important for people to tell your story. Now, D, this is what I tell people. I said, you know, you should write a book. And they go, you know, and I said, listen. Other people can tell your story because they, from their perspective, and that's okay. But I said, you lived it. You lived the story. No one can tell it like from your perspective because you lived it. What do you say to that, D?
Well, that's absolutely true. In fact, the man I was telling you about earlier first wanted me to ghostwrite his story. He gave me 8 large 3-ring binders full of newspaper clippings and pictures and just so many things. And he said, okay, here, you can just write my story. And I thought, there's no way I can do this and do it any justice because, again, he was the one who did live it. He was a news helicopter pilot, one of the very first ones in the country to go live with the news while he was flying. And sometimes he was the news because he would rescue people off of mountains, you know, hikers and out of rivers. And it just became an amazing story that he told in his own words. So, yeah, nobody can really tell your story the way you can because they can write down the facts and the details and the background. You know, they can do the research, but only you know what you felt and what you went through during that time. And that's what's so important, not just the details, but the feelings and the emotions and the struggles that you went through. Nobody else really knows that.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Speaking of no one really knows that, Felicity, is it possible for you to do a monologue for us? Do you have anything in the pocket for us?
No.
Okay. What about, do you do improv?
No, I'm not an actress myself. I just run events for actors.
Oh.
Yeah.
But you look like an actress, though.
No, I'm not an actor. I actually, since I've been in New York, I actually have done some improv classes just for fun.
Yeah.
And to network and, you know, meet lots of performing, lovely performing people. But I full-time am founder and director of Actors Pro Expo.
Wow. Mm. Now, which cities have you done thus far?
London, Manchester, Edinburgh, and now New York.
Wait a minute, London, Manchester. And what's the other one?
Edinburgh.
I'm not familiar. I've heard of it. I'm not too familiar with...
It's in Scotland.
Oh, okay.
And then, and now New York. So, yeah, that pretty much takes up a lot of time.
So, wait a minute. I'm thinking all the time that you did acting.
No. I run these events, Actors Pro Expo.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's pretty, what's in your hand? Like, really? I like that. It's almost like Laurie with, you know, with being cheeked. You came with this idea.
Yeah.
And I'm impressed. I am very, very impressed.
Thank you.
But you still got to do a monologue. No, I'm just kidding. I had these guys. We did an event. I celebrated 500 shows a couple of weeks ago. And I had this gentleman. I knew he was in the acting world. He did some comedy. And I called him. I said, hey, I want you to do this piece for me. He's like, you know, he didn't have a lot of time. And he was like, he had a lot of excuses. And he was like, you know what, I'm going to give it a shot, Rick. And he did it. He did a great job. There was this book, this gentleman wrote a book called 12 Universal Laws of Success. And he actually wrote a script, and they performed it. And everybody loved it. Everybody loved it. So that was pretty good.
Great.
All right. Now, Lori, I already asked Dee this question. Who do you see? Who do you see playing you in the movie of the Cheeked movie? Who's going to play you?
That would be me.
Really? You do acting?
Kind of.
So I guess we're going to see you at this workshop then.
Who's got time for a workshop? I have a dating empire to build.
Okay.
I just signed a contract with a production company in L.A. to do my story.
So wow.
It's a new reality show.
Whoa. What do you think of that, Felicity?
I think that sounds amazing.
A new reality show. Dee, how do you feel about reality shows?
I enjoy some of them. I used to watch Big Brother, but I got over that. The one I like the best now is Amazing Race.
Okay. Yeah. Now, how do you see your story and what you do, how you see that into a reality program?
Well, you know, in a way, there was one, although this had more to do with genealogy, but there was a show called Who Do You Think You Are? That was more about genealogy, but it still was helping people to find their ancestors and learn about their stories. Unfortunately, because those people, most of them, didn't leave journals, all they could find out is where they lived and what they did and, you know, what the, whatever they could find out by searching records. But just imagine if those people had left a journal behind or a book about their life, how amazing that would be. So, yeah, my reality show would be similar to Who Do You Think You Are, but with the stories. Maybe I would take somebody like the client I've been working with, the helicopter pilot, and have him, you know, do a half-hour segment.
Right.
Yeah, that's my show. I decided I want a show.
Okay. All right. And me too. Me too. I'm here in the studio with amazing guests. I think that that's definitely a reality show. And, you know, I just called up a gentleman. I don't know if you caught this part, Dee. I called up a gentleman day before yesterday, and I interviewed him back in, I think it was around 2008, and I found out from his brother-in-law that he passed away.
And
he did an audio program called Five Disciplines of Powerful People. And he said, this is a quote that he said, Dee. He said, when you master yourself, you master the universe.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. When you master yourself, you master the universe. I thought that was pretty powerful. When you hear a quote like that, Lori, what becomes present for you?
I got a lot of work to do.
Okay. And Felicity, when you hear that quote, when you master yourself, you master the universe, what become present for you?
I think, yeah, pretty similar. You know, I think that I am 26 and I've got a lot of living and a lot of learning to do. And, you know, yeah, so I think, yeah, same as Lori, actually.
Ksenia, yeah. What becomes present for you when you hear that? When you master yourself, you master the universe.
You have to be careful. You have to be careful because what you do affects a lot of people and the universe. So you need to make sure you master yourself in the right direction.
Dee, when you hear that term, when you master yourself, you master the universe, what becomes present for you, Dee?
Well, my thought is, I don't know that that'll ever happen in my case, but, yeah.
Why do you say that?
I don't know. I just think it's very hard to be as disciplined as you need to be to master yourself. My biggest problem sometimes is procrastination, and, you know, I've been dealing with that for years and years, but...
Okay, so here's what we're going to do. I want to bring you on often because I like what you do. I think that you have a potential to help a lot of people because a lot of people need to tell their story, Dee. So I would like to bring you back.
Okay.
I have a guest that I had on my show maybe like a couple of months ago, and she's an expert in procrastination. So maybe I could bring you guys on together.
Oh, that would be fun.
Okay. Now, when you hear the term, what's in your hand, what becomes present for you, Dee?
Even as far as myself, what's in my hand?
What's in your hand?
Yeah, I feel like I do have. One thing for me is I really feel like I'm going to be 70 this year. And okay. I feel like I have finally found my calling in life. You know, I raised kids earlier, and I didn't get into doing this until I was 60, in my mid-60s by the time I started working with clients. And I just feel like, you know, I have finally found what I was supposed to have been doing all my life. So this is kind of what's in my hands. I get to work with amazing people that have just fascinating stories. And I love what I do. That's why I defined that as success. I feel very successful right now because I finally have found something I absolutely love doing.
There you go. And that's so ironic that Felicity here is 26. You're 70. And how old is Lori Cheeks? She shook. She had a convulsion going on.
I'm 41. I'm a young 41.
Okay.
It only gets better, Lori.
I'm looking forward to it.
Mm-hmm. How old are you, Ricky?
Who?
You.
I'm an owl. I am an owl. Wow, so this is interesting. This is very, very interesting. You get my student, my boxing student, calling me out on the air. You're going to pay for this on, when we have our next class again, Tuesday, she's going to pay. Lots of push-ups. Push-ups. Lots of push-ups.
I might be out of time.
Okay. So, Lori, I appreciate what you do. Lori, what's in your hand? What becomes present when you hear that term, what's in your hand?
I think the future, actually. You know, I've really surrendered everything that I knew and all my money and everything that I'd learned in life to build this business. And now, you know, I've got this deck of cards physically in my hands. And this, it's all about fate, you know. Missing opportunities in life, and I feel like these cards and my vision and my mission are all about capturing opportunities, and the love of your life might be passing you by. You can slip them a cheat card, and you can look at this business concept in any form of your life. Just pay attention to things because there's magic everywhere. And
is those cheat cards for a certain age?
No, they're non-gender specific. They're good for anyone that's single, hopefully above the age of 18. With
Felicity, are you married yet?
Yes, I am married.
Oh, okay, so you won't be cheeking anybody. I guess you could cheek your husband.
I say that when your relationship doesn't work out, you can buy a deck of cheat cards.
No. Okay, well, no, wait a second.
I'm kidding.
Wait a second. Is it possible for her to cheek her husband?
Yeah, you can write whatever you want on the cards, so you could even put a date idea on the card.
Mm-hmm. There you go.
There we go.
I like those cards. D, are you married?
Yes, I am. 41 years.
41 years. Wow. So you can cheek your husband, and he can cheek you, too.
That would be fun.
All right. I'm not an expert on relationships, but I would say that I think that you have to keep it fresh and interesting. And would you agree with that, Felicity?
Yeah, I mean, I only got married 6 months ago, but I've been with my husband for 11 years.
Wow.
Before we got married. So yeah, I mean, I would definitely agree. But, I mean, Dee's probably more of an expert in marriage than me.
It's a lot of work, but it's worth it.
Right. You know, it's work. You know, relationships are work. No matter what kind of relationships they are, they can even be boxing relationships. And sometimes they're just challenging. Anyway, Lori smiling. What are you thinking, Lori?
You're funny.
Okay, that's cool. I'm having a good time here. And I love the work that all of you guys are doing. And we have about... Time is flying. Hold on a second, guys.
WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
Did you come up with, like, all the lines yourself?
Yeah, most of them.
Yeah. But you say like, you say people like can write whatever they want, right? So then you can use it. Like,
yeah, so we have a section on the site where you can pick from our line. Yeah, so if you like one of them, you can get 50 of them. Or you can, I mean, people have written some pretty funny things. Like one guy must have gotten them to use at church because his said, "I bet we read the same Bible scriptures."
Now, how do you get to write what you want on the cheat card?
So you can go and buy a custom deck of cards on the internet, and you just type out the cards that you want. But they can only have this much on them, so we stop you. So you have to get creative in a short space. So
almost like Twitter.
Exactly. But even it's 41 characters. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Less is more sometimes, especially when you want to capture someone's attention quickly.
Okay. You know what? I'm going to play. Let me see something here. Let's see what we got here. One second. That was a little bit of Mary J. Blige. So Felicity, what's gonna happen at the Actors Expo? Just give me a breakdown of everything that's gonna happen there.
Yeah, so an actor will.
This is the first one in New York.
This is the first time we're in New York. Yes, the first time we're in the States.
Okay.
So an actor would attend the event. They'd walk around the big exhibitor room. They'd meet all the different vendors. They can sign up for an open casting slot, so they can audition for the film Funny the Movie. And then they can
Funny the Movie,
yes. So that's the feature film which is casting at the event. And then they can also come along and do some seminars and workshops. They're only $20 and they last an hour.
We can't quote prices.
Okay.
So, but the workshops are, there are a fee for the workshops?
Yes, yeah, small fee for the workshops and seminars. But if an actor came along and didn't want to spend any money, then they could still have an enjoyable day. They can go to the open casting call, they can meet all the exhibitors, vendors. They can also put their resume and photo in the casting director drop boxes. So there's still a lot people can do if they don't want to attend any seminars and workshops.
Now, what about someone like me who's not an actor, but I'm going to go there, and what about someone like me? What's going to be there for me?
So, I mean, for someone who's a non-actor, if they wanted to come to the event and they've got some kind of interest in acting, then it's just an opportunity to meet people who are actually doing acting and find out, hey, you know, why do you love it so much and what are you doing here? And also, you know, meet the vendors as well, because you can meet people who are, you know, actively in the industry and learn more about what the industry is. But yeah, it is more aimed at, you know, people who are already in the acting industry, to be honest.
And but for me, is it possible for me to go there and get some great guests?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, you could probably go along and network with people. Absolutely.
So what type of?
It's a pretty big event. There's about we've got over 1,000 people registered to it.
Wow.
Yeah. So it's a pretty big day. It's an expo. In London, we have 3,000 people that attend. And so, yes.
Wow, 3,000 in London.
Yeah, 3,000 people. But that's been built up over 5 years to 3,000.
Yeah. I think that the best actors are probably in Russia. So we need to do one in Russia.
Definitely.
An Actors Expo in Russia.
Definitely.
You know, they wear those big furry hats, you know.
Yeah. And bears playing balalaikas. Yeah. That's what's going to happen.
Okay. All right. So, Dee, how are you doing over there?
I'm still here.
Okay. So what's the first step if someone wants to write their story? What's the first thing they need to do?
Well, what I tell people, if they're writing their own and they don't know where to start, they should just start making a list of all the major and some minor events of their life. So just anything that comes to mind, sit down with a piece of paper or on the computer and just brainstorm. And so you might have a list of 100 things that say something like, you know, my first day of school, or when the dog bit me, or my first date, or first kiss, or how I met my spouse. You know, just anything like that. Challenges, talk about jobs, military career. So start with a list, and then go through and prioritize of all of these things. Some of them you're not going to care to write about once you see it on the list, but of all these things, what do you most want your grandchildren to know about you, or whoever you're writing it for? And so prioritize those, and then just pick one story. The thing I tell people do not do is don't try to start at the very beginning and write the whole book in chronological order, because you'll get so bogged down it's not funny. But just write about the things that are interesting to you at the time. Start each story on a new page and put it in a three-ring binder, and then when you feel like you're finished, when you feel like you've written everything you need to say, then you can take all those stories and put them in order. And this applies whether you're writing on the computer or by hand. Most people do it on the computer, but still print it out and put it in a binder, because that'll help you to organize it and sort it and, you know, see it and handle it.
Laurie, give me a success story other than yourself, someone that has used the cheat cards and had great results.
So I don't know of any marriages yet, but I have I do know that there's a lot of messaging going on within the site, and you know, it's hard to follow because it's a physical thing when people are handing these cards out. But I know several of my friends have handed cards to strangers on the street, and they've been out on dates with them, and often friendships evolve from the dates that don't even work out. But one of my best girlfriend slipped a guy a card that says, "I bet we'd fold laundry well together." And he wrote her a message and said, "I didn't realize we had a laundry facility in our building." So it turned out she gave him this card on the street, and they actually lived in the same building together.
Mm-hmm.
So what are the chances of that?
Wow.
So now she knows her neighbor.
Wow. But she didn't know that he lived in a building.
No, but he recognized her because of her dog.
Wow. Okay.
And had seen her in the building.
Wow.
So if now, he doesn't call her back, then yeah, she knows where to right. find him.
Now, Lori, where are you from?
Kentucky, originally.
Kentucky. Do you know that one of my people that I really admire is from Louisville, Kentucky?
I know who that is.
You know who that is? Is it someone that floats like a butterfly?
Stings like
and
a bee.
And stings like a bee? Maybe that might be Muhammad Ali.
Yeah, I've been on 2 flights with him from New York to Louisville.
Wow. This may shock and amaze you, but I'm going to retire Joe Frazier.
No, he has such an amazing presence. When he came through the airport, you would have thought the president was coming through.
Oh, wow.
They had him in one of those little golf cart things, and everyone in the airport started clapping. It gave me chills.
Wow. Well, you know what? Everyone on this show today has presence also. And I'm excited about everyone that's here. And maybe, you know, Laurie, I mean, I'm saying Laurie, Felicity will go through the airport one day and people will be like, hey. Be on a little, one of those little carts. And so this is interesting. So anything, now, what do you think about what Felicity does with her acting program? What becomes present for you when you think about what she does?
I mean, I think it's so great, just the in-person contact. And I even like that you had us all come here when we could be calling in. I mean, I know Dee can't get here with us, but I do think so much more about being face-to-face with someone, and I think there's a power behind that that you can't replace with connecting with people over over the internet.
Now, we don't know what might happen with these relationships, because, you know, for less, you just don't know. She might know someone that could benefit from your cheat cards.
That's true, and now that I'm single, she can slip that card to a good-looking guy that can find me.
Yeah. Yeah, and then what do you think about what Dee does with her telling her stories or helping people to tell their stories?
Well, I think it's interesting because for years people have told me that I need to write a book, and I feel like I don't have time, and I wouldn't even know where to start, but now I do. Dee,
so what do you say to Lori, Dee?
That's amazing, good.
So, Dee, I got, that's 99 more. We got one, so we got 99 more I got to find for you. I'm going to find you 100 people to tell their story. So, that's one.
Okay.
Yeah. Now, Dee, what do you think about what Lori does?
Well, I just think that's fascinating. I never in a million years would have come up with that idea, but it's very clever, and I really admire her for, you know, having an idea and following through with it. Because a lot of us have great ideas. I've had so many great ideas. I have invented so many things in my life, but either they're not on the market or they're on the market because somebody else did it. You know, but I've done it. I've invented things in my mind. So for her to follow through, I think that's just really great, and it's a really cute idea.
Go, Lori! Go, Lori! Go, Lori! So, Dee, what do you think about what Felicity does? I thought she was an actress.
Well, I did too. That's how I was writing her book, was as an actress.
And right.
Yeah.
Wow.
So now I'm really intrigued and curious about how, not being an actress, how she got into.
I know. I'm even more impressed
with working with actors in that way.
I'm even more impressed that she's not an actress, that she's doing this.
Yes.
What's in your hand, Felicity? What do you think about what Lori does?
I think it's I think it's great. You know, it's like I was saying, there's actually similarities between the two, because we're mixing online world and real world, and I think that you know, seeing someone in the flesh, and you know, maybe not, I don't think I'd have the confidence to go up to someone and say like, oh hi, you know, do you want to have a coffee or something? But I think having something like this makes it so much easier, because you're able to kind of see someone that you really like and just give them, you know, and give them a card. And then on your online profile as well, when they see you, they know that those photos aren't fake, or those photos aren't, you know, just like Google images that you found and you've put up there, you know, that you are who you say you are. So it's like the safest way of online dating.
Yeah. Because I know somebody that when they go to the gym and they see muscles, all of a sudden they get excited. So maybe they could pass one of these cheat cards. There's a certain person in this room that when they see muscles, they get excited. They love muscles. So what could I say? She's smiling. So Felicity, what do you think about what Dee does with helping people to tell their story?
Yeah, I mean, again, I think that's absolutely amazing. You know, it's brilliant when you do things like this, and you learn, and you learn about things that you didn't even know existed. You know, I didn't even know that existed, and it, you know, it's, you only hear about famous people that write these autobiographies. You don't actually hear about real life people doing it. And everybody's got a story to tell, whether or not you're a famous athlete or you're, you know, someone who has, you know, not become famous, but also had a really interesting life. So I think that, I think it sounds really great.
Well, and the other thing is that this show, the Rick Young show, What's in Your Hand, is the only show that you're going to hear guests giving assessments on other guests. Usually it's about me. I have an article, a Time Magazine article, they said this is the me generation. But I love the fact that you guys are sharing and giving to one another. I think that's powerful, beyond even words. I think that's really powerful, and I really admire all of you guys for doing that. So, Dee, I'm going to go back to you. Dee, who's in Arizona, Gilbert, Arizona. Dee, what do you think of this young lady who... Russian lady who come to boxing and came all the way to support me to give me support with this radio show early in the 4 o'clock in the morning waking up. What do you think about the support that she's giving me, Dee?
Well, I think that's really nice. I'm not sure why she did it, but I think it's a great thing that she did. I know that, well, actually, I was up at 4 o'clock in the morning in Arizona to do this.
The reason why she did it, Dee, I'm going to tell you why she did it. Hold on 1 second. Let me take a station ID, and I'm going to tell you why she did it.
WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Rick Young in the studio doing What's in Your Hand, performing What's in Your Hand, cheeking What's in Your Hand, and acting What's in Your Hand. In the studio, I have Lori Cheeks. She has a business called Cheeked, how to help people find the love of your life, possibly by passing them a card that said you've been cheeked. And I have Felicity Jackson in the studio, who's doing a Actors Pro Expo workshop here in New York. It's really awesome. April 26th on 2014. And in Arizona, I have, in Gilbert, Arizona, I have D's. And she helps people to write their life story. She's called the Life Story Lady. And D, let me have your website.
It's lifestorylady.com.
Life Story Lady. Let me write that down. Lifestorylady.
.com. Right.
Okay. And Felicity, let me have your website. Felicity?
It's actorsproexpo.com.
Actors. With an S.
Actors.
An S. Pro.
Pro.
Expo.
.com.
.com. Okay. And Lori, let me have your website.
Cheeked.com. That's CHEEKD.com.
Okay, CHEEKED?
No, just D.
Just D?
Mm-hmm.
Cheeked.com. Well, D, the reason why Cassinia came here with me this morning to support me with this radio show, because she's just a wonderful person. She's a really nice, caring, kind person. And she's smiling as I'm saying this. But I really appreciate it. You know, she came. We had a couple of other students from the class that kind of bailed out. And she said, hey, I'm coming. I'm coming. Here she is. So I thank you, Cassinia. Appreciate you. And I'm wearing my Rocky shirt. They took me to see Rocky on Broadway. It was a great show. I really enjoyed it. It was a lot of fun. And I laughed all the way through. And do you know that Rocky went to Broadway? Did you know that, Lori?
I think I read that somewhere.
Yeah, it was really funny. And the funniest one of all was Apollo Creed. Oh, my God. Apollo Creed was really funny because he was, like, dressed up all sharp. And he had two ladies or three ladies?
Three.
Three ladies that were with him all the time. And they were sort of, like, singing and dancing. It was great. It was a funny story. I laughed all the way through. So I enjoy Rocky. So thank you, Cassinia, for my class took me to see Rocky.
Oh, how sweet.
How wonderful. Now what I needed was some cheat cards.
Yeah. We can set you up.
When I was at the Rocky show. All right. We're almost, oh wow, look, we're at the end. So any final words, Lori, that you'd like to share about your cheat business? And let me ask you this. You're really active on social media, like really active on Twitter, Facebook, and what else?
I'm on Pinterest, Instagram, Tumblr. We have a WordPress blog. I mean, I feel like I'm all about the in-person encounter, but social media is a pretty magical tool to spread the word to people that don't know about my vision.
Uh-huh. Well, let me just tell you guys this. I had a guy on my show, I think last week, last Sunday, and he has a business called Dot Club. And what he said is that the internet is going to be like the Wild Wild West again. Remember when you had all those .coms, when everybody was buying those .coms and selling them and making all this money? Well, it's going to be like that again, but the way it's going to be different. Like, so instead of being cheeked.com, it'll be whatever cheeked.
Right.
You know about this?
Yeah.
You know about this going?
I do.
Yeah, I had the guy on my show.
You have to pay a lot of money for those. So if I wanted something called cheeked.cheeked,
yeah,
I'd have to pay an arm and a leg for that URL.
Okay, okay.
Which I don't have right now, but I will.
Okay. But you could, there's a way that you can kind of work around that?
I think it cost a lot of money, period.
So they got the dot clubs. They paid a lot of money for
probably,
that dot club?
Yeah, I would imagine.
Well, you can make, you know, you, I think you can make some things happen.
I'll get to it.
So what do you think about that, Felicity, that this internet is going to be really like the Wild Wild West and with all these, you know, dot, different dot names now?
I've never heard of that before, and so I don't really...
Are you active on social media?
Yes, yeah, I'm on Twitter and Facebook. Well, my business is on Twitter and Facebook, and then personally I'm also on Instagram. I don't know anything about this dot Wild Wild West stuff.
Well, we're going to keep you posted, because you got a new friend now, Laurie. Mm-hmm. Did y'all exchange information?
We will.
We will. We will.
And Dee, you got new friends. So Dee, do you know about this thing that's going to be taking off with the internet?
No, actually, I had never heard of that.
Okay, we're gonna get you posted on that. Keep you abreast, because we need you to help a lot of people tell their story. Felicity, are you interested in telling your story?
Yes, yeah, absolutely. I mean, at some point in my life, I would absolutely love to do something like that.
Yeah. Okay. Well then, D, 98. We got 98 more.
Okay.
Well, plus me, so that's 90.
Well, thanks, Rick. I should just hire you.
Yeah, so that's me, 97. So you got 97 more. Ksenia.
Sure.
Are you interested in telling your story?
Of course.
Wow.
Okay, great.
So that's 96. I think we have to go for 1,000, because like 100 is going to be easy.
I think so, too.
All right.
I think, Rick, this time next year, all four of you should have your story done.
Okay.
And we'll meet on air and share bits of it.
Okay. There we go. I like that. Felicity, no one or D, any final words that you want to share with us because we're at the end now? D?
Oh, me?
Yes.
I'm sorry, I thought you said Felicity.
I did, but I changed
it. Just for anybody listening and for those of you there, I do think it's important for everybody to write their story. And honestly, even though this is something I do for clients, it's something that anybody can do on their own. It takes a little bit of self-discipline as all, but just sit down, start writing, and you'll be surprised at what comes to you. It doesn't have to be a big book, just something, you know, a few stories to share.
Dee, I like what you do. I love what you do. I want to help people tell their story. That's going to make a difference in so many people's lives to be able to tell their story. So, Dee, I'm doing what I'm telling my guests not to do, hit the table. I'm banging the table and I'm so excited. So, I'm going to be fined for hitting this table now. I'm going to charge them. So, Dee, you got my word. The four of us are going to do our stories, and we're going to help a lot of people tell it. I think I think it's important for people to tell their story, because then once you leave here, if people don't know you, they won't know your story.
That's
once
right.
Once you're gone, that's it. So
exactly.
So thank you, Dee. I appreciate what you're doing.
Well, thank you for having me on, Rick.
Felicity, any final things that you'd like to say about the Actors Pro Expo?
Yeah, just for anybody that's listening, whether you are an actor or you've got any interest in acting, then pop along on Saturday the 26th.
Pop along.
It's free to attend. You can sign up before on our website, actorsproexpo.com, and just spend an enjoyable Saturday at a trade show.
Okay, I want to thank you. Give me your website again, Felicity.
ActorsProExpo.com.
Laurie, give me your website.
Cheeked.com, CHEEKD.com.
And D, let me have your website again.
LifeStoryLady.com.
Okay, let me just say this. I've said this before, you know, when I did the show on we have an organization here called WEBT, where we're helping people with disaster preparedness. And I was saying that this is one of my greatest shows. But this show that I'm doing this Sunday, Easter Sunday, is going to be incredible. It's an incredible story. And someone, I'm not going to tell you what it is, but someone told their story. And it's going to be powerful. So this is Rick Young. I'm signing off. I guess I'm going to sign off with some Mary. Can we go with some a little bit more Mary? I'll see you guys on Sunday. It's going to be a powerful story, guys. Thank you. Thank you, Dee. I appreciate you.
Okay. Thank you, Rick.
Thank you for listening.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Lori.
Thank you. Dee, what's your Twitter handle?
Dee?
That's Life Story Lady also.
Okay. I'm going to look you up.
Okay.
Okay. All right. And Cassinia, thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Keeping your word.
Absolutely.
Don Miguel Ruiz says, what he says, honor your word. What's that quote from the four agreements? He says, I can't think of what it is. Something about you. Honor your word. Be true to your word. Anyway. All right, guys. Anyway, I'll have it for you on Sunday. Don Miguel Ruiz quote about being true to your word. I will see you Sunday. Mary.
Yo, what's up? This is Mary.
Peace. Hey, yo, Matt, be here, pick up. Yo, Matt, be here, pick up.
Yeah, what's up, man?
Yo, what's up, nigga?
Yeah.
What's going on, man? Yo, I'm driving uptown, man. I'm vexed, man. Niggas out here front, man. Say you can't do it again.
Every day, and I know that you love me. Baby, admit it.